not permitted. The use of cameras and recording equipment is strictly prohibited in the auditorium. Thank you for your cooperation. Enjoy the program.
Thank you. ensemble concert. What you just heard, a phallocentric lecture by Nigel Westlake, has become a standard piece of percussion ensemble repertoire, particularly for mallet ensemble, which is the theme of tonight's concert. Not just music for mallet ensemble, but what I would refer to as music of the new canon for mallet ensemble. So mallet ensemble's history is with a lot of transcriptions from the beginning of the 20th century, a lot of ragtime music, and these pieces that you're hearing on tonight's concert are some of the more recent and more modern pieces that I would consider mallet ensemble pieces, because they're for either exclusively mallet instruments or mostly mallet instruments. Like, as you noticed in the last piece, there were a couple of percussion instruments besides the marimbas. But throughout this program, you're going to hear three marimba quartets, one mallet octet that includes vibraphones, glockenspiel, and chimes, and then the last piece is a sextet for six marimbas. So if you noticed in the last piece, Omphalocentric lecture is very much based on African marimba music or African xylophone music. There are a variety of different cultures in different countries in Africa who use various kinds of predecessors or predecessors of the marimba or the xylophone. And so I think what it has in common with that music are what we call cross rhythms, where sometimes you might have found it was hard to tell where the beat was, where you thought you knew where the beat was, but then there was something that obscured that beat because there was a simultaneous cross beat happening at the same time. So for example, that piece is in four most of the time, but there's also this overlying groupings of six, and then the piece ends in six and finally transitions, utilizes that cross rhythm of six and goes into six for the ending. And then once he does that, even though it's written in six, it kind of sounds like it's in four, which is one of the things that I think is really cool about it. This next piece that we're going to play was premiered by the Rowan Percussion Ensemble, and it's written by an old friend of mine who started off as one of my teachers. He was the drumline instructor at Barnum High School's marching band. And so James Ieraci was one of my father's students at the time, taught me there. We've actually got a couple of Vine High School alum in the ensemble besides myself. And James is an internationally performed composer, Rowan University alumni, as I just told you, and his piece Mediation, composed in 1994, is his first of several minimalist pieces for percussion ensemble. Two pieces on tonight's program, six marimbas and the one you just heard in phallocentric lecture, provided inspiration to Dr. Ieraci on both six marimbas, both six marimbas and Mediation feature contrapuntal writing, phasing, rhythmic construction, interlocking repeated patterns. Meditation is dedicated to Dr. Ieraci's maternal grandmother who died the year the piece was composed. Currently, James is composing two independent film scores and a new piece for keyboard percussion ensemble entitled Sublimation of Dreams. So without further ado, we will hear James Ieraci's Mediation for Marimba Quartet. want to acknowledge James Ieraci. So this next piece that we're going to play, I think you'll find pretty contrasting to the first two pieces that we've heard. It's not a minimalist piece for the first one on the program so far. Pawassar's sculpture in wood has become a staple in the Mallet Ensemble literature, like I told you, which is the theme of tonight's concert. It's one of the most frequently played pieces for Mallet Ensemble. It's done quite a bit. There's also a trio version that's done fairly often as well. And I think it's really a nice piece that has a lot of different influences in it. I won't maybe pinpoint any of them per se, let you guys, leave that up to you guys, but I will tell you to listen for a couple of different melodies that get introduced and built upon in kind of the traditional sense of how you might expect melodies to be worked through in a piece. And they intertwine at some points, and he builds on them and utilizes them to go in a couple of different themes and a couple of different sections and brings all of it back together at points, overlapping and interlocking together before reintroducing the section at the end that, like most music, brings back material from the beginning of the piece. So without further ado, this is Sculpture in Wood. We have a bit of a set change before we do this next piece called Spun by Nathan Daughtry. Daughtry writes about this piece. The title Spun is derived from the term fortspinum, which means spun out or spinning forth, which was a term employed by Wilhelm Fischer in 1915 to describe the developmental, often sequential middle part of the ritornello in Baroque music. If you don't know what the ritornello is, that's a repeated section that occurs in a lot of Baroque music, particularly in concertos. So if you guys are into Baroque concertos, maybe you know what I'm talking about. The composer would take a short musical idea or motive and spin it out into an entire phrase or period. It may be used to expand the pace or accelerate the pace of the piece. In Spun, the short musical idea forms the primary theme and serves as the pitch set for much of the composition. The first 59 measures utilize only pitches from this set before exploring other chromatic key areas. As the piece spins forth, the rules set forth are quickly broken and the theme expands, becomes the accompaniment, acts as the root for the chord progression, but is always moving forward. Additionally, after the slow and ominous introduction, the quick perpetual motion of the piece, primarily set in 12/8 meter, creates the impression of a dizzying spin from beginning to end, taking the listener on a journey through many moods and emotions. The piece was commissioned by Dan Armstrong, a friend, colleague, and mentor of mine, who's the percussion teacher at Penn State, commissioned for the Penn State Mellow Ensemble, and received its premiere on November 30th, 2010 at Penn State University in State College, Pennsylvania. I think what you'll notice about this piece is, first off, this is the first piece that's going to use anything other than the marimba. So we add in some of our metallic and our percussion instruments, like the vibraphones you'll see, crotales in the back, and chimes and glockenspiel in the back, as well as four marimbas again in this piece. This also is the first piece, I don't know if you've noticed, all of the pieces leading up to now have been unconducted. So this is the first piece that requires me to conduct the ensemble. And I would just like to inform you that when this piece is done, we're going to take a brief pause, so not an intermission, about 5 minutes, to reset the stage for Steve Reich's Six Marimbas. Reich's Six Marimbas is a very important piece in the history of percussion ensemble. Steve Reich is very important in the history of music now. He's one of the only living composers who can say that he's in the history books currently. Most of the guys in the history books are long since passed, but Steve Reich is alive and well, and he's in the history books. So this piece, Six Marimbas, is very significant for the development of the percussion ensemble, particularly the mallet ensemble. So it was the focal point of this concert, which is why we're playing it last. So I built this program knowing that we were going to play Six Marimbas, and I tried to pick up the pieces that I thought complemented in such a way as to match with that theme of the new canon of mallet ensemble music. It looks like we're good to go, and so you'll hear Spun, and then we'll have a brief pause, reset the stage for Steve Reich's Six Marimbas.
Thank you.